This is a synopsis of the Deceit syndrome by Paul Hobday. Rob Bajant is an experienced NHS GP, the only job he ever wanted. Becoming more and more alarmed about the extra misery and sickness he sees on a daily basis, his concern turns to anger when he realises this is a direct result of government policy. His patients are suffering and his beloved NHS is being dismantled by political zealots. An ideology has been dictating all our lives for decades, but few have ever heard of it. Even fewer could explain it. Most have been brainwashed that this is the only way. Neoliberalism has taken over the world, imposed dishonestly, undemocratically, and by stealth. It affects every part of our lives from cradle to grave. Where and how we are born, educated, work, play, consume and die. Even the afterlife has been privatised. Rob now understands the long-term clandestine plan to commercialise healthcare so that a small group can make their fortune. Why can't others see it? Friends and colleagues ridicule his protests. Even his new wife thinks he is a little paranoid. But the more he looks into it, the more he grasps that the plan goes far beyond the NHS. There is a sinister establishment plot for big business, mainly from the USA, to take over literally everything, including government. It will be irreversible. Bajant is amazed to learn the elite and the appeasers before the war sowed the seeds. Rob realises these people will go to any length to change the world to their advantage. But who are they? Who can he trust? And why is he being threatened? He begins to fear for his own safety. Nothing is allowed to get in the way of this revolution. Most of the scandals in Rob's lifetime seem to be linked. They all begin to make sense and fit together. Will the world wake up in time, or will evil prevail? Can he help turn the tide against the forces of the establishment, or will he go under first?